Hey, what's up, guys? I know what you're thinking. This isn't Doki Doki Literature Club. Trust me, it will be Doki Doki Literature Club. Before we get into this, I just want to let y'all know that I am 100% an idiot. Let me explain. So, in this game that you are about to watch, there is a big majority of this game where you cannot see me. You can hear me, but you cannot see me. At some point, I do realize that that is a problem. Hopefully, you guys stick around long enough to figure out when. But anyway, hope you guys enjoy the video. Welcome back, everybody, to Doki Doki Literature Club. It's Sunday. Not really. This is actually Wednesday. But, anyway. We're not gonna look too much into it. But, looks like the skip button is available, so let's go ahead and push the skip button. That was a very short skip. I'd be getting really... I'm just adding words into this. Let me actually do this properly. I've been getting increasingly anxious about Yuri's upcoming visit. I keep telling myself there's no reason to be nervous, but it doesn't help much. Yuri is clearly an introvert, and also an intimate person in general. There's no doubt that she'll open up a little bit when it's just the two of us. Meanwhile, I've even been texting occasionally. She was extremely apprehensive at first, but it wasn't long before I already learning more about her. But putting Yuri aside... Oh, skip button. This music kills me. So, yeah, that was our heartfelt moment with Sayori. You can always go back to watching that moment. It was a very powerful moment. I felt like it was very good for the relationship that we had that conversation. Alright. As I approach my house, I see something that makes me feel a moment of panic. Yuri? Thank goodness. You're a little early. I'm sorry I wasn't home yet. Were you waiting for a long time? No. I just got here. But I started to get really nervous when nobody answered the doorbell. You always could have texted me. If I had known, I would have reassured you and hurried more on my way home. Ah, I suppose that's true. I didn't think of that for some reason. It should be common... She's not talking. There's nobody talking. It's just me thinking. It should be common sense to do that. But I decided to ignore it. Anyway, let's go inside. I see you brought a lot of stuff with you.
That's right. And did you manage to find everything I asked you to buy as well?
Yeah, pretty much. At least, I hope I got everything right.
I'm sure it will be fine.
I take Yuri to my room. I'm going into my room.
The first thing she does is glance around curiously, which makes me feel anxious. It's so clean.
I cleaned it before you came over, so...
That's very considerate of you to do.
No. I would be really embarrassed for my room to be a mess while you're here.
Well, I do enjoy cleaning. I would have gladly helped you clean.
Ah. That would be even more embarrassing. Wait, don't look in there.
I snatch Yuri's wrist, which was the process of opening a desk drawer of mine.
I wonder what's in the desk drawer. Probably some dirty magazines.
I'm sorry. I wasn't thinking for some reason. I was just spacing out.
It's fine. It's fine. I let go of Yuri's wrist. She puts both her hands firmly in her lap, as if making sure she's keeping track of them.
So, should we get started?
Yes. I have a few things planned that you can help with. Decorations and other atmospheric enhancements.
Atmospheric enhancements?
You know, mood lighting.
Aromatherapy candles.
Oh, wow.
It's okay, guys. I know I'm not great with reading.
I didn't know you planned on taking it that far.
Of course. I want to help take our guests to a faraway place.
Although, many will stop by just out of curiosity. And for cupcakes, I guess. I'm determined to provide an experience that will leave them wanting more.
That's great. It's easy to forget that you're a pretty intense person.
Intense?
I guess that's the best way to put it.
Is that a bad thing?
No, not at all. It's something that I like about you, actually.
Is that so? That makes me feel relieved. And kind of happy.
Yeah. No need to be so anxious. You can relax a little.
Relax. I brought some things for relaxation. I was going to use them during the poetry event.
Oh yeah? Like what?
Let's see.
Yuri rummages through her bag. She pulls out a few candles and a wooden cylinder-shaped object.
I did some shopping on the way here, so I happen to have these in my bag. I plan to cover the windows in black paper and use the candles to light the room. I think that would be amazing, don't you?
Yeah, that would be really neat. Neat. What's that wooden thing, though?
Oh, this? It's a diffuser for essential oils. How familiar are you with aromatherapy?
Not familiar at all. Same.
Is that so? It's one of my favorite contributors to the positive atmosphere. Depending on the oils or herbs you choose, you can change the mood of the air itself. You can even feel it permit through your body. Relaxation, positive energy, romance, reflection. It's almost like magic.
Yuri takes the cylinder and pushes a switch on the bottom. In just a moment, a thin ray of vapor begins to spout through a small hole in the top.
Wow, that smells wonderful.
What kind of mood is that one for?
This is jasmine essential oil. It smells a little sweet and flowery, right?
Yeah, that's a good way to describe it.
I choose jasmine for the event because it provides more than relaxation. Jasmine enhances your emotions and helps you feel them flow through your body.
I like where this is headed.
You feel warmer.
Mm-hmm.
And your heart pounds more heavily.
Yes, it does. I like where this is going.
Don't you think that will be perfect for sharing our poems?
It'll be perfect for something. It does sound suitable. But you seem to know a lot about this, so I'll trust your opinion with anything. Yuri smiles gently, clearly enjoying herself. She again reaches into her bag and pulls out several spools of thin ribbon. What are those for?
Well, did you purchase the origami paper I asked you to get?
They have specific origami paper?
I thought you just used regular paper.
Yeah, I have it over here.
We won't be using the paper for folding origami.
So what are we using it for? To write things?
Oh.
What I like to do is write different words on each paper.
I couldn't just read. If I had just read it, I would have... Yep, anyway.
Well, need about 100 of them.
It's too much. Bring it down a couple notches. Nobody's going to be coming in for literature.
Oh, yeah?
What will those be used for?
Well, I'm going to cut pieces of ribbon to hang from the doorway of the classroom. Then we can fasten the paper onto the ribbons to create a doorway curtain. Wouldn't that be beautiful?
Sounds messy after a while.
It would also catch the eye of those passing by the room. It may attract some to peek inside.
That's really creative.
I had no idea... Excuse me, something popped up on my phone.
I had no idea you'd be so good at this, Yuri.
Is that so? Well, I suppose I do get a little intense, as you'd put it.
I don't think that's how you do that, but I'm gonna do that. It's funny to me, anyway. Sure. Yuri giggles with red cheeks.
Is it just me, or she...
This is supposed to be my thought, I'm sorry. Is it just me, or is she more relaxed when it's just the two of us? Or maybe it's the enhancements, or excitement, she feels. The enhancements. She definitely got something done in the chest region. There's no way those are natural. Anyway, the excitement she feels from sharing something that she enjoys. I can relate to that. I get really excited to share things with people.
Here's a marker, Royce. You can write any characters you want.
Why do you phrase it that way? What do you mean by that?
I'll help you once I finish cutting the ribbons.
Ah, all right. Sitting on the floor together, the two of us get to work. I carefully draw a different character on each paper, doing my best to manage my bad handwriting. I also have bad handwriting. I can just totally relate to both of you guys. Yuri unravels a long strand of ribbon to her desired length. Then she reaches into her bag once more and pulls out a pocket knife.
Eh?
The knife is strangely beautiful. The silver handle, as it interacts, an intricate pattern of waves etched into it. The blade itself is gently tinted blue. I apologize. I cannot read today. That's no ordinary pocket knife. It's a switchblade. It looks really fancy.
Well,
embarrassed, Yuri looks away.
What is it? You're going to think it's weird.
Yuri, whatever it is, I have no reason to judge. To each their own, you know?
If you promise you won't be weirded out.
Yeah, I promise.
All right. The thing is, I'm kind of into knives. They're just so pretty. I can't help it. I don't know what it is, The combination of craftsmanship and feeling of danger, maybe. What am I saying? Please don't think I'm weird for this. You're laughing at me.
No, I'm not laughing at you. It's just funny how nervous you got about sharing. It's, well, it's an interesting thing to be into, I guess. But I think it kind of suits you.
Suits me?
Yeah, it's kind of intense. Besides, it's really cool-looking knife. I can't deny that.
It is, isn't it?
Yuri relaxes her expression once again.
Would you like to hold it?
Sure, I'll check it out. I'm gonna end up cutting myself. I said it was a switchblade. I'm gonna cut myself. Cut my finger right off.
Yuri carefully hands me the knife with the handle facing me.
You know how to handle a knife.
I take it and turn it around in my hands. It feels heavy and extremely solid.
Where do you even get a knife like this? Curious of its sharpness, I feel the point of the knife with my index finger.
Ow! Rice! Why did you do that? I didn't expect it to be that sharp. I barely touched it at all. It's my fault. I should have warned you. This knife is extremely sharp. It can cut through skin like it's paper. Oh no.
A small drop of blood tickles down the side of my finger. Yuri takes my hand and gives the wound a closer look.
She stares at it and noticeably fidgets. If you're squeamish, I'll go wash it off now.
Ah!
Without warning, Yuri puts my finger in her mouth and licks the wound. I feel her tongue curl around my finger. Startled, I instinctively pull my hand back.
Oh. Please forgive me. I wasn't thinking.
Yuri lowers her head, her face burning up.
Yuri.
That's the most embarrassing thing I've ever done. How could I do something like that? I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Sure, it was a little weird, and it took me by surprise. But I guess she was just trying to help, right?
Yuri, I think you're overreacting a little.
She doesn't lift her head. What if she doesn't recover from this for the rest of the afternoon?
Alright, you know what? This might be a stupid thing to do, but I do it anyway. I take Yuri's hand and lick her index finger in return.
Royce! Did you really just do that?
Now we're even.
Yuri just looks at me like I did something wrong.
I knew that would be a bad idea. If not for the sweet aroma of jasmine oil, the air would be extremely heavy right now.
You're so weird, Royce.
Yuri giggles shyly.
Eh? Yuri calling me weird? I have no response to that.
Where do you keep your bandages?
I don't think I need one, actually. It was a tiny cut. Look, it's already stopped bleeding.
I see. That's relieving.
The tension is quickly lifted. We each resume our respective activities. I watch Yuri's knife cut through the ribbon like it's nothing but air. Meanwhile, I continue to make progress on the paper. After we finish attaching the paper to the ribbons, we lay them all out side by side. It looks better than I expected, and will be very
effective as a door curtain. It looks great. Good thinking coming up with this, Yuri.
Thanks. It's just something I saw online, really. Are you ready to move on to the next task?
Yeah, let's do it.
What do you have in mind? I'd like to create a banner. That's why I asked you to buy the paint tape.
Tablets. Paint tablets. That's right. One of the items Yuri asked me to buy was a kit of watercolor paint tablets.
We'll need about 6 cups of water to put each of the tablets in. Do you mind fetching those for us?
Of course not. 6 cups of water. I'll be right back in a minute.
Thank you very much. Oh, and just a little bit of water is okay. If you fill the cups too much, it will be too diluted.
Taking Yuri's advice, I decided to use small plastic bathroom cups rather than full-size glasses. I put them on a plate to catch any paint that drips and bring them back to my room. Yuri?
Yes?
I come in to see Yuri quickly unrolling her sleeves, pulling it back over her arm. Nothing. Your face is a little red. Is it too hot in here or anything?
No, not at all. There's nothing wrong, so let's mix the paint.
Yuri hurriedly dismisses me and takes it upon herself to unwrap tablets, dropping them into the cups.
So, I thought we would do something simple that would look very nice. I'd like to paint a gradient across the banner, starting with colors for a sunrise, then daytime, then sunset, and nighttime. Once it dries, I'll write an inspirational quote across the banner. We can hang it on the wall behind the podium in front of the classroom.
Ah, neat. That's pretty neat. Sorry, I'm getting anxious my own self. What are you gonna write?
Well, it'll be more fun to surprise you.
Yuri smiles at me. If you say so. After rolling out the banner, Yuri and I kneel on opposite sides so we don't get in the way of each other. Yuri uses brush and adds a few dots of different colors across the banner to serve as a color guide when we paint. This kind of reminds me of elementary school. Painting on a banner with watercolors feels a lot like the art class projects we had back then. It's relaxing.
Huh? I'm sorry if it feels too childish.
No, I didn't mean it. I didn't mean that at all. It's kind of fun, you know?
Yeah, it is fun. I'm glad you feel that way too.
Yuri stops painting for a moment, thinking to herself.
For me, I don't need to go out and do crazy things to have fun. In fact, I usually don't even want to. I just like when I can spend time with one other person. Even if it's something simple like reading, it doesn't even matter if we don't talk much. Just having a friend next to me makes things feel a little bit nicer.
I can relate to that 100%.
I think that's all it takes for me to be happy.
Is that so? Even if Yuri and I are quite different, I understand where she's coming from. She's not different. I'm pretty much the same with her. She's just a lot more intelligent than I am. There ain't a whole lot going up here, you know. I feel that way about things like anime and games. We're simply sharing the experience with someone can make me happy. Yeah, I can relate to that too. I think I feel the same way.
Yuri smiles gently. I knew you'd understand.
Yuri leans over the banner to grab the unused paintbrush, but I move at the same time, causing my head to bump into hers.
My head. Sorry.
Yuri reels back, and I quickly lift my hands in surprise.
Are you hurt?
No, I'm not hurt.
Just startled me, that's all.
Sorry, I should have asked you to get it for me.
It's not your fault. Your face. There are droplets of paint on Yuri's face and neck.
Is there something on my face?
Yeah, I accidentally got paint on you. Sorry, it's totally my fault. I'll get a towel right away. I rush out and fetch a small towel, then I dampen it with hot water. I return to my room and kneel back down in front of her.
Oh, this is the moment. This is the moment, guys. We've been waiting for this.
Here. I pat down Yuri's face and neck with the towel.
Is something wrong?
It's hot. I just didn't expect it.
Sorry.
I didn't want to use cold water. Having finished, I start to retract my hand. But Yuri suddenly holds my wrist.
Wait.
Eh?
Just for a little longer. It feels really nice.
I keep my hand still against Yuri's neck. She looks into my eyes.
Hey, how you doing?
It's an intense expression that I recognize from when she reads her books. Almost as if she's lost in a daze, enveloped by her own thoughts. She breathes gently, halfway through slightly parted lips. What is happening? Is it the aroma of the jasmine oils giving me this dizzy feeling? Yuri's gentle fingers wrapped around my wrists send a tingling sensation through my arm. And suddenly her face seems to be much closer to mine than it was just a moment ago. Yuri slowly pulls away.
Sorry. I've been feeling a little lightheaded today. I didn't mean to space out. It's fine.
The moment is over as soon as it began. Yuri picks up her brushes again. But her movements seem clumsier, like she's unable to focus. I remain silent, forced to ignore the event that just transpired. I hastily retrieve my own brush and continue following Yuri's example. That should do it. I finish feeling the night sky and white dots that look like stars. Looking at the banner as a whole, it's very pretty, natural looking.
I think it came out better than I expected. I'm really happy with the results.
Yeah, me too. Are you going to add the lettering now?
Not yet. It needs to dry first.
That's true. But won't that take a while?
Well, perhaps it would be best to leave it here. Then have you bring it in the morning. I can do the lettering in the classroom before the event starts. Is that okay?
That's totally fine.
Wonderful. In that case, I don't think there's anything more for us to do here. Phew. You say that like you're glad it's over. Was I wrong to assume that you were at least enjoying yourself a little bit?
No, it's not that. I'm just glad that we managed to get everything done.
I see. I am too. I was a little concerned about time. I need to start making dinner soon.
Eh? So you don't have any time left? I was secretly hoping we would have extra time after finishing the work.
Well,
Yuri thinks to herself,
I think it would be too irresponsible of me to wait much longer. I'm sorry. I was hoping there would be more time as well.
It's probably my fault. Sorry for being such a slow worker.
No, it's not your fault at all. And the important thing is that we got everything done, right?
Yeah.
So, I shouldn't be disappointed or anything.
Gathering all her things, Yuri seems to look a little downcast. I understand why. It sounded like she rarely gets the opportunity to spend time with friends in a relaxed environment. But that doesn't mean that this is the last time it can happen. Once Yuri packs up, I walk her out to the front door.
Thank you very much for having me today.
No problem. I'm glad I was able to help. Just let me know if there's anything else you need me to bring tomorrow.
I will. Well then,
Yuri fidgets.
I guess I'll see you tomorrow.
Wait. I kind of say that without thinking. About today. It's fine that we didn't have as much time as we wanted, because we can do this again. Whenever you want, you can come over, or we can go out somewhere. Ah, I forgot you don't like going out much. As I stumble over my words, Yuri simply smiles bashfully. Anyway, you know what I'm trying to say, so...
You're very thoughtful, Royce.
Yuri takes a step closer to me, then briefly squeezes my hand.
I kind of like that about you.
Well, how am I supposed to respond to that? But I don't even get a chance to, as Yuri suddenly pulls back.
Sayori.
Hi, Royce. Sayori. Just now we weren't...
Hee hee.
It's okay, Royce. I just stopped by to say hi.
Well, it's nice to see you. I'm sorry, but I'm already... on my way to leave.
Really? That's too bad.
I'm sorry. But we'll all be together at the festival tomorrow, so... So that's fine, right?
Of course. Sayori beams.
Yeah, so... I'll see you tomorrow.
Clearly embarrassed, Yuri hurries off. Sayori waves goodbye after her. And time for the skip button. Okay, so... Last time, we... told Sayori that we love them. So now we're going to see what happens if we say this. I'd like to point out that I don't want to say this. I would say this. That's always my true answer is I love you. But we are going to see new stuff. So let's go ahead and try this.
You'll always be my dearest friend.
What you need most is for things to be like they've always been. Monika told me the truth. She told me how much happier you seemed after I joined the club. I know you're struggling with some really difficult things right now, or feelings right now, but please trust me that I know what's best, and what will make you happy in the end. I promise I'll help get things back to the way they were.
I see.
Sayori forces a smile through an incredibly pained expression.
Is this what it feels like? To get stabbed in the chest? I should write a poem about this. Sayori, it's okay. This is just my punishment, remember? For being so selfish. So please, please don't worry about these stupid feelings. I know you're right. I knew this whole time that there's no happiness down that path. That's why I came here. Just so I could get the answer I needed to hear. And the other thing. You're also right that I just want to go back to the way things was. Go back to the way it was. I realize that now. You really do know me better than anyone, Royce. I'll trust you with anything. Anything at all. So, Sayori smiles. Sayori's smile finally breaks. All of a sudden, she turns around and drops to her knees. Clutching her head with both hands, she screams as loudly as she can. I'm so shocked that I don't know how to react. Sawyer looks over her shoulder and flashes me one more weak smile before turning around and running off. Sayori! I'm left helplessly standing in front of my house. Why am I feeling so horrible about this? There's nothing more that I could have done. The most I can do is support Sayori through her feelings and help her on her path. That's right. But I'm having as much trouble understanding Sayori's feelings as she is, even though I can comfort her. I keep wondering if I should be doing something more or something different. I know these thoughts will continue to plague me until things are back to the way they were. I'm going to give it everything I've got. Sayori will always be my dearest friend, and I'll do whatever it takes to put a smile on her face every day. Well, I'm going to go ahead and stop it right there. Oh no. Oh no, guys. That is crazy. I just realized you guys cannot see me at all. Give me one second. Oops. You guys have not been able to see me this entire time. Well, that is unfortunate. It's not like y'all really needed to see my face. It's not like it's a horror reaction kind of thing right now. It's just kind of like story time. But, yeah. I wish I'd have caught that beforehand. I definitely would have fixed it earlier. But, anyway. Went through 38 minutes without actually being able to see my face. I apologize, guys. But that's okay. We'll keep moving forward. Anyway. Thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw and you want to see more, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. If you want to help the channel grow, go ahead and share it with your friends, family, on Facebook, Twitter, or any other social medias. And as always, I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.